Hello, I have been using Postman, which is a tool for testing the APIs for quite a long time. Recently, I have came across a wonderful feature in Postman, which allows us to put placeholders or variables in places where we could have different values per environment. So we are going to see in this video how to use variables with Postman. You can see on my Postman screen here, I have this field or this placeholder called ingress-ip or ingress_ip, and it shows the initial and the current values. And then I have the regular path which I want to send the get request to. It's sending a request to an endpoint called account or named as account with a parameter, some value. If I send this request, you will see that I get the output here. And same way, I have various other functions or various other methods. Again, a get call, which calls the account with a different parameter. And when I send, it gives the output in multiple values here. I also have an account version here, which is another endpoint that it is trying to hit. All this URLs, they have this ingress IP as a variable. So how do we define this? This is a very handy feature when we want to send similar requests across different environments. And Postman has this concept of environment. We can create different environments, and there is also the option to have a global environment setting. That is what I have used in this case to define a variable called as ingress_ip. And I can specify this as a default or a secret. In this case, I want to put it as a default value. And we specify the initial value, and we can also update this with a different value. In my case, both the initial and the current value are the same. And then whichever API call I want to use that variable, the global variable, I can use this ingress_ip. And if I go and try to edit this, you will also see that there are other variables that I can use. So when I try to put a placeholder using the angle brackets here, there are things like timestamp, ISO timestamp, random integer, random phone number. So these kind of things can be put as part of the input variables or as part of the variables in the path. I hope you found this useful. In case you like this video, please hit the like button and subscribe to the channel. And do let me know in the comments what other kind of videos you would like to see on this channel. Until next time, code with passion and strive for excellence. Thanks once again for watching this.